consider the truss shown. So we have a truss here with 8 bars and 5 nodes, and I'd like to go through the process of setting up the compatibility matrix for this system. So the compatibility matrix is A, and it's the matrix that if I multiply into the nodal deflections of the truss, gives me the change in lengths of the bars. So if I multiply by the diagonal matrix of 1 over the bar lengths, I get the strains in the bars. So let's go ahead and have a look at how we develop the matrix A. And we're going to get one entry or one row per bar, and so it's when multiplied by U, it's supposed to give me the change in length of the bar. So if I look, for example, at bar 1, I can have a generic displacement U1. Of course, we know it's 0 in this problem, but that doesn't matter. And at node 3, I have a displacement U3. If I want to know the change in length of the bar, what I can do is I can project the deflections onto the vectors that are running parallel to the bar. So this term here, that is going to be E31 transpose U1, so that gives me the projection. Or if you want, you can write that as E31 dot U1, doesn't matter. It'll be a little bit easier to use this transpose notation. So we think of all vectors as column vectors. If we transpose them, they become rows. And this term over here, that's going to be E13 transpose U3. So the change in length of bar 1 is E31 U1 with the transpose plus E13 transpose U3. Okay, and then divided by L will go ahead and give me the strain in bar 1, or divided by L1 rather. So we can go ahead and do this bar by bar. And so let's go ahead and set up the matrix A. So we already have for the first bar, it's going to be E31 transpose 0 E13 transpose 0 0. So I'm going to have a set of block columns for each deflection that I can possibly have. So this is, so let's write it out this way here. It'll be maybe a bit easier to sort of build it up in pieces. So we're going to write it out like this. So epsilon is equal to 1 over L A U. So we'll put our 1 over L here, and then we'll put our U here. So U1, U2, U3, U4, and U5. Okay, so we can see that when I multiply this first row into this column, I'll get U1 acting on E31 transpose, and I'll get U3 acting on E13 transpose. So we can go ahead now and work our way through the truss. So if we go to bar 2, we're going to have U1 acting on the vector E21 transpose, and we'll have U2 acting on the vector E12 transpose. Added together, that's going to give me the change in length. There's only 2 entries per row, and they should have swapped subscripts. If we go to bar 3, which is over here, then it connects with nodes 2 and node 4. So I'm going to have entries 0, node 2 is going to act on the vector E42 transpose. And on node 4, I'm going to have E24 transpose. So it's always the vector that points outward from the node. If we go to bar 4, that connects nodes 3 and 4. So 0, 0, and then E43 transpose. And E34 transpose. And we have to have one row for every bar in the system. So now we're at bar 5. Bar 5 connects nodes 3 and 5. So 0, 0, and then E5, 3 transpose, 0, E3, 5 transpose. So again, it's the outward normals. Bar 6 connects nodes 1 and 5. So that'll be E5, 1, the vector that goes from node 5 to 1. Then 0, 0, 0, E, 1, 5 transpose. So that's the vector that goes from 1 to 5. And we still have two more bars to go. So we have to do bar 7 that connects 5 and 2. So 0, E, 5, 2 transpose. 0, 0, E, 2, 5 transpose. And then last bar is bar 8, connects 4 and 5. So 0, 0, 0. So in the fourth column, I'm going to have E, 5, 4 transpose. And in the fifth column, I'll have E, 4, 5 transpose. So this here is A. That's the compatibility matrix. And when I multiply by U, and then I divide through by 1 over the bar lengths, then I end up with the strains in the bars.